The Moon versus the Geminids. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plaw Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. This week, we're going to answer a question from one of our viewers. John Zimmerman of New Jersey writes, "Dear Stargazers, I've seen a lot of meteor showers, and I've always wondered, why are some meteor showers better than others?"
Excellent question, John. This week, our planet Earth will intersect the path of an asteroid named 3200 Phaethon, and we're usually treated to what can be a very good meteor shower.
However, this year, our nearest neighbor in space is going to ruin some of the fun. What are we talking about? Let's show you. To answer John's question, a meteor shower occurs whenever our Earth rides directly into a stream of space debris and the little pieces of debris slam into our Earth's upper atmosphere and produce visible streaks of light. We call these streaks of light meteors or shooting stars.
You see, every time a comet pays a visit to the sun, it sheds part of itself. And eventually, as the comet makes a lot of trips to the sun, the entire orbit of the comet gets littered with comet debris. And whenever our Earth crosses a well-littered cometary orbit, we get hit with this stuff and experience what we call a meteor shower.
The meteor shower we're experiencing next week is the Geminid meteor shower, and back in 1983, it was discovered that the object responsible for the Geminid meteor shower is not an ordinary comet, but an asteroid, or perhaps better named, a rock comet.
After a comet has made a lot of trips to the sun, all its snow and ice eventually melt away, and only a solid core is left. We then call that solid comet core an asteroid, since it's no longer capable of producing a cometary display.
Therefore, what we're experiencing here is debris from a comet so old and worn out that it no longer has the stuff to put on all the show and wonder of a brilliant comet head with a long tail of gas and dust, such as Comet Hale-Bopp. So, while we will never ever again see a brilliant comet associated with the Geminid meteor shower, we will continue to experience the Geminid meteor shower itself, which is one of the two best meteor showers of the year, the August Perseids usually coming in as number one. This year, the peak of the shower will occur on Tuesday, December 13th, after dark, right through to sunrise Wednesday morning, December 14th. However, unlike previous years, this year might be a washout on the night of the peak because of our nearest neighbor in space.
That's right, James. Our ever-popular and lovely natural satellite, the Moon, will be in a bothersome location in its orbit this time around. It will be in the waning gibbous phase, which will put it above the horizon during the best part of the shower.
Fortunately, the Geminids is such a dense meteor shower that it usually puts on a good show for several nights before and after the peak. So, beginning as early as December 7th to as late as December 21st, you can see quite a few meteors associated with the shower without interference by the Moon.
So, to finish answering John's question, this is a major reason why some meteor showers are better than others. Although the timing of the peak of the meteor shower stays pretty much the same every year, the phase of the Moon is always different on the same date each year.
Therefore, if your meteor shower is ruined by a full moon on December 13th one year, a year or so later, the Moon will be in a waxing phase on that same date, putting it below the horizon during the meteor shower's peak and thus making the fainter meteors easier to see.
To watch the Geminid meteor shower, get comfortable in a lawn chair or sleeping bag and constantly scan the sky back and forth. It's good to be far from city lights and have a clear dark sky to catch the faintest of the meteors.
And again, it helps if you can get outside before the Moon comes up.
So, watch our Earth impact the remains of an asteroid over the next 2 weeks.
And it will be such a lovely impact, particularly if you remember to
keep looking up.